Hi all, welcome back to more Space Engineers. Hal here, and as you can see, we've got our large butt miner out here. I just went and did some mining over on the moon. Basically needed some more iron, because we're running out of iron. I had to take some of the plates that I'd already made apart, so that we would have some resources to do a little bit of building. So I figured while I was out and about trying out the new miner, you know, I might as well go ahead and grab something useful. So we went ahead and did a little bit of iron mining, you know, just to get it there. Alright, so I need to pull forward just a little bit. It's, nose are down. Alright. And how is that for... A little bit forward, there we go. And hopefully, there we go. And we can kill the thrusters. Okay, so now that we are down, I have to say I really do enjoy having a ship that I can pressurize, because it means I don't need to worry about having my helmet on all the time. Now, the one thing I didn't do is because I didn't use the vented hallway pieces here. Basically, this stays sealed, so there's no way for me to pull the oxygen out without actually having a vent somewhere along the hallway. But that's okay. We don't mind. That's got turned around here for a second. Let's put our helmet back on so we don't suffocate. And we jettison ice. Okay. Go ahead and close that up. Yeah, happy Thursday everybody. For the folks in the US, happy Thanksgiving. For everybody else, well, hope you're having a terrific week. Most of the folks on this side of the pond are off today, unless you're working retail, and at which point you may be going into work a little bit later after you get to spend some time with your family. But hopefully, yeah, everybody that's on the channel gets to kick back and do a little bit of relaxing today. It's, you know, it's a good day to just hang back, have some fun with the family, and you know, just enjoy yourselves. Alright. So let's go ahead and get all of this off of our... Well, we're gonna keep that. So, I had somebody ask if I could do a smaller build. More like a small utility craft, like a drone style. So what I'm going to do today is that's actually what I was planning on doing anyway. So I'm going to use some of the parts from the industrial cockpits and more, which is done by another YouTuber who you may or may not know, Video Sage, or Ectosage, depending on how long you've known him. So what we're going to do is we're going to set up a very small, let's see. We want this. Yes, I know that it's small only. Okay. So let me show you the difference here between this one and this one. So you have a thin seat. Let's see if we can get into a little bit of light here so you can see it a little bit better. All right. So you have the thin seat, right? Which is basically one block by two blocks, I believe. Let's show you what this thing looks like here. And then you have the regular seat, which is the seat itself is the same size, but the box size is different. So this is a 2x2 grid by, I think it's 2x2 by, well, is it 2x2 by 2x2 or is it 2x3? I think it may be 2x2 by 3, where this one is the, yeah, it's 1x2 by 3. So, this is the one we're going to use, and what we're going to do is this is actually going to be the control point for a new drone. Well, I can't call it a drone because it'll have a cockpit control on it, but it'll be a system that we can use as either a drone or as a pilotable ship. So first things first, let's go ahead and grab some plates. I need to grab, let's reorder that around there a little bit. Let's go ahead and grab 100 of each. I know I'm not going to need 100 of each, but you know. So let's see if we can get this thing a little bit better squared up. We're going to move back this way just a bit. There we go. And construction components. Okay. So, leave it to Sage to give us something that requires the components as the starter piece. Okay, so let's try that again, shall we? So we're going to go ahead and put this down here. Alright, so that's the beginning of our ship. Doesn't look like much, but that's okay. It doesn't need to. So what we're going to do is we're going to build... The first thing we're going to do is we're going to build a small drill... a small drilling utility craft. So, with that idea in mind, we're going to go ahead and bring this up. We want our reactors. I'm going to do a large reactor for this thing. And let me make sure we've got... Alright, so... see, the large reactor, man, I really don't want to have a, I don't want to have to do an array of reactors, but I may have to, so we can do for cargo. All right, so we're going to do a large cargo. Well, you know what? I may need to go ahead and let's go ahead and do the normal one. This way we can square it up. I don't like my ships being offline like that, off center. All right, so there. Okay, so can we... Okay, so we can do it there. So let's go ahead and do it this way then. And what we're going to do is we're going to put... a little bit of backing here. All right, and so that's basically where our chair is going to sit. So I want it there instead. So we want to take... that one off. We're going to place it with that. Now we're going to go this way. And that way. Alright, so that gives us, you know, where our chair is going to be. Alright, and then from there we're going to do this. We want that to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so we want that to be there, so that it's... you know what? Helps if I have that... Oh, I was gonna say, please don't drift away. This is what I don't like about the new system. The new system is not good, in my opinion. Alright, so, we've got that, we've got that. We need this to be centered up there. All right, and like I said, this is a mining craft. So what we're gonna do is we need, let's go ahead and take this stuff off. Oh, since we are using, well, that says hydrogen thruster. Does he have an ion thruster? I thought he had an ion thruster in this. No? All right, we're not doing those. But what we will do, because this is a small ship, so we're not going to be able to use the piece that we want, We're gonna use these instead. We're gonna go hex hub. Okay. Wow, that's will that work? So I know it'll work here. You know what? Let's do it this way. Because what this will allow us to do is to have, let's see, I think there are converters that go from, yeah, there's a converter T joint. So what this block does is it allows you to take, well, it's supposed to allow you to take a large to a small. I don't think that is the one that I want. I want, I think this is the one I want. I want it, I want. Woo-hoo-hoo. Sorry. And yes, that is, this one is the one that I believe will allow us to do what I'm trying to do. And actually there's a spacer one too, I believe, right? Yeah. So we'll take this out. That in there. That one there, and then we go number 7 to there, which I believe should line up. We will see here shortly. Actually, we'll take both of those out. Now, the main reason why I am doing it this way is because I like my designs to be a little bit cleaner. So I don't like having, yes, and yes, all right, so I don't like having things just kind of there if they don't need to be. Go ahead and grab this one's conveyor, T-joint, X-joint, mini conveyor tube, okay. So yeah, but basically what I'm going to be doing is I'm trying to keep my lines as clean as possible. I really don't like having certain things that just, you know, when they don't match up well, just something about it bugs me. So I like to have my stuff with a clean, with clean lines and being elegant enough to basically get away with whatever we need to be doing. All right, so we got all of those. Now we're gonna go, because of the fact that, well, you know, I'm not a huge fan of the vanilla drills. They irritate me because they have very limited range and their extraction rate is, you know, poor to say the least. And this is going, oh, I forgot, we're on small ships. Oh, crud. Oh, I want to. Oh, see, I wanted to do this all nice and elegant, but no, it's not going to work the way I want. So, what that means is we're going to have to rebuild. Okay, time for a redesign. Let's see here. Which is fine. I've had worse things to have to deal with. So what we can do then is, this actually might work out a little bit better. There we go. Because now I can use, I can just use this on both sides. Which means that I can actually put connectors on any side of this now, which will hopefully, you know, be a little bit better for us long term. Right, so let's go ahead and get rid of this. And this, we need the mini T connector. And we need our mini conveyor pipe. There we go. So our mini T connector should go here. Which way are we? Is that the right way? No. That's metal. Okay. So we need to go like that. Yep. Awesome. And what I'm doing is I'm just basically looking at the outline. As you can see here, you've got the hazard tape that tells me that's one of the openings. There's hazard tape there. So we got hazard tape, hazard tape, hazard tape. So that means that is our, that should be the right connection there. We go 8, let's flip that. Connect, connect. And then we're going to do the same on this side. That gives us an active connection from the reactor back to cargo. And now we just need to wait for the computer to catch up to me again. All right, that's good. All right, and then we're going to go from there to here. To here, we're going to do... let's see, let's go with... Should have... It's an L. That's a conveyor hex hub. Do we have a small conveyor hex hub? That's the X joint. Hex joint, okay. Now, because what I want to do here is we're going to put this one here. Right? If we can get it to actually attach, thank you. Put that one there. Make sure that we're still symmetrical. Yes, okay. And then we're going to have a drill here, here, and then another drill here, there, because the little drills, I've said it before, I'm not a big fan of them because of their extraction rate, even with the twin drills. And this is, I'm not gonna lie, this is some like ridiculous amounts of overkill for this type of design. Because what we're gonna end up doing here now is bringing this down. So we can do that. And one more here, one more there. And this is straight up just how ridiculous can we make this thing? Because, you know, anything worth doing is worth having fun with, right? So we're going to do this, 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 that. Now, that is a lot of weight to have on just the cargo, on the cargo connectors. So what we're going to do is we're now going to reinforce this with all of our iron here, because we want our blocks. We don't want these things to go drifting off into space. Yeah, it's just a bad idea. Right? So, what we're going to do is say this, Leave that open for thrusters. Let's see here. Let's get rid of this. We're going to do the L block. Okay, I can't really see. Oh, see, I tried to turn on my light. There we go. See if that helps any. Alright, so. There we go. Much better. Okay. Really? Oh, come on. I swear, this game, man. Sometimes... Shush. Alright. There we go. There's some days that I just have the worst time with the controls in this game. And like I said, we're gonna have our thrusters here, so we're gonna go like that. But basically what we're doing is we're just trying to make sure that each of the blocks have multiple connections to the structure itself. And then what we'll do is we'll run some framework back behind all of this so that we can get all of the... Come on. Oh, come on. Really? Are you freaking kidding me? There we go. Sheesh. Alright. See, I'm usually much better with my placements than this, so... But that's okay. We'll make do with what we got. And we want number 5 there and there. There we go. So, now everything is, in theory, connected together on the ship, right? We've got our drill assembly, we have our storage assembly, we have our reactor. And what I'm going to do is, like I said, we're going to have some thrusters basically peppered through this area. We're going to have this open for thrusters here. We're going to have, again, more thrusters. Basically, we're going to have thrusters on both sides of this, pointing both forward and back. We're going to have a thruster array back here, and then we're going to have some thrusters probably end up doing a thruster harness around the ship itself. Okay, so once again, it's hanging up there. There we go. All right. And now I'm thinking I may even do another row of, like another cluster of the mine, the drills, up above. Starting to wonder, do I really want that much drilling on either side? Because that's... I'm starting to look at it going, you know, that might be too much overkill even for me. Yeah, even though we have the materials. There we go. I'm thinking that that's, even for me, that's a little too much. It would be funny, but eh. Okay, so it just means we have to rework a little bit of our design here. Alright, so we're gonna go take that out there. Take that out of there. Okay, so we're done with the drill. Let's get our thrusters out. Small, I need large steel tubes. Okay. Hey, I can build four. All right, so how many blocks? That's from here is going to be one, two. I think this should be enough. Right. I know three a three space is. So we'll do this way. Right. And then down here, we can actually do. Oh, need more tubes. Let's grab some more tubes. All right. Let's go pick up the. Let's go drop those off and those off. There we go. That's better. And what we'll do for down here is we're going to flip these so that we can go one, two, and three. Because when you are drilling, if we have to go vertical with this thing, I want to make sure that we have enough. So that's one, two, three. Is that going to be. I may need to take out that block. We'll see. We'll see how this works. All right. Now, since we've got that done, let's go ahead and put in. That's going to attach us there. So, are you? You should be above that line. Yes, okay. One, two, and three. And from here we go two and three. That gives us lateral controls, acceleration, deceleration, or I should say forward motion, retro motion. And then we just need a bunch for lift. All right, so. And for those, we are just going to do basically the same thing we did up top. It might not be a bit. Oh no, I don't want that. I want that block. If I'm going to put anything in there, it's going to be an armor block. All right. Okay. Once again, sorry for the continuous hang-ups. Like I said, I do think that some of the scripts that I'm running are basically causing problems. So I'm going to go through and try and figure out which of the scripts are causing the issue. Oh, sorry, puppy. My pup is under my desk here, laying on my feet. So when I adjust my feet, he gets whomped. So I always feel bad about that too. All right. Oh, come on. We just recovered. Yeah. This is why I normally restart before I do space engineers. I'm not sure why it has gotten so bad. It didn't used to have this type of problem. So I'm thinking it's either something in my system, like maybe there's a memory leak or something, or the game has lost some of its optimization when it went to the DirectX 11 requirement. Because it seems like since they've removed the DirectX 9 stuff, it's been much more wonky, so. Okay, come on. I would like to get at least some of this done today, if possible. All right, so we've got that. Now what we're gonna do here is one, two, three. We're gonna do three more on this side. Can I get the fourth one in there, or is that blocked? No, that is blocked. What is that blocked by, I wonder? Oh, I just need steel tubes. So I can get the fourth one in. All right. That's a good thing. Alright, so let's go ahead and get those in. Because like I said, I want this to be pretty much self-sufficient. Okay, and then the only thing we're missing at this point are the I don't know what you want to call them. The vertical controls for negative direction. Because we have ascent, descent thrusters. That's what I'm trying to think of. All right. Now the question is where do I want to put them? I'm thinking. So we're going to put a connect. Let's put a connector back here. So for these, we'll go ahead and do it like so and like so. And we got a lot of mass up here, so I'm not quite sure. So I really don't want my thrusters to be in a situation where they are at risk, if that makes sense. So I guess we can do it like that. Oh, nope. Come here. All right. Man. Hey, this is where I actually need the little drone from Imperion. All right, so. Okay, so we've got this done. Let's go ahead and add in a little bit of protection materials here. Basically just trying to tie it all together. In here so that we can hopefully play the jigsaw puzzle game. And let's hope that this ties, this provides enough support that the ship doesn't pull itself apart. I have had that happen before. It's funny until it happens to you. There we go. And I think that's gonna about do it for this. I will come back and reskin, or actually apply a skin to the ship, but I wanted to go ahead and get all of this in first, so we have most of what we need. We still need gyros. And I'm thinking that we're going to put the gyro here. So we've got one gyro there, and we'll put the other one, we'll put another one on this side. Okay. Now, in theory, this thing should be done. We've got thrusters, we've got gyros, we've got reactor, we have cargo, we have everything piped together. We have control system. Okay, so the last time I said everything should work, it died horribly. So I'm gonna go inside, we're gonna throw the switch, and we're gonna see how this thing works. So, ready? Almost a little anticlimactic. We're probably missing thruster components. Oh, something else finished. Give it a couple more seconds. We keep seeing things just kind of pop every once in a while, so I'm not sure. Alright. I'm guessing, looking at it, we are missing thruster components. So let's go ahead and queue a couple of hundred of those up. We actually should have the materials for it now. Let's go... 500 should be good. And then if we turn this back on, as they finish up, we should start seeing the engines coming online, more or less. So, looks like we may have our small utility craft here. Give it a couple more seconds. Anything left? No. Okay. Don't want to get too close to the window because, like I said, when everything is fully retracted, this is a kill zone right here. So stay out of the window. Alright, so we're going to do this. Come on. Thank you. I really should just go ahead and set up the airlock system. Everything looks like it's attached. Everything's good. So the only thing we need is a little bit of uranium. Okay, so let's go grab... You know, let's go ahead and put this stuff in here. We're gonna grab, I don't know, like, Lunar Miner, Waypoint Large. Okay, let's grab, let's just go grab 10 out of here. It's not meant to power everything up indefinitely. Of course, I may need to put a connector on this. Yeah. I'm gonna need to put a connector on it because I can't get to... see, I knew I forgot something. Energy. I need to build... Oh, look. My reactor's actually offline. Yes, I know there's no fuel. Let's see. Large reactor is the only thing that's incomplete. What are we missing for this? Didn't it used to tell you what you were missing? Can I get in there? I'm guessing I'm missing reactor components. Alright, how about... Yes, some missing reactor components. Okay, that's easy enough. Let's go ahead and build those. But I'm going to go ahead and call this one here. Where is that? What are we missing for that? We're missing iron. Do we not have... This dropped off a bunch of iron. Really? Hey, you. Get out of there. Why am I not able to get that around? Interesting. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and get all of this sorted out, get the irons up and running so we can get this reactor built. When we come back next time, we should have the little ship built, and we'll see how she handles. Until that time, thanks for stopping in. If you enjoyed it, make sure you hit that like button. If you have any questions or comments or suggestions, always feel free to... throw them down in the section below the video. Actually, we're going to go this way because it's a little bit faster and I don't have to walk through the entire station. If you're new here and haven't done so already, I do ask that you subscribe, as the likes, the comments, and subscriptions all do help the channel to grow. It's greatly appreciated, and it also allows me to know what content you enjoy. It's just an easy, quick check for me to say, you know, I can see what everyone likes. And that's what I want to do, is I want to make more of that. So if you're enjoying it, make sure you're letting me know. Anyway, I'm out of here. I hope you all have a fantastic week. If I don't see you before then, have a terrific weekend. And once again, for the folks on this side of the pond, I hope you have a safe and happy Thanksgiving, everybody. As always, folks, take care and be safe out there, everybody. It's been a long day.